Fatima is a great source and grace and hope for the world. There are many stories of Fatima, and for everything to be told would be like an encyclopedia. One of these stories became better known since the beatification of the woman often called the fourth seer of Fatima, Alexandrina Maria da Costa. Some of the pilgrimages that go to Fatima visit the town of Balasar north of Fatima. It became famous in 1832 when the earth changed to form the appearance of a large cross that you can still see today inside a chapel which has been built over it. Almost exactly 100 years later, in the same town, Alexandrina Maria da Costa started suffering the Passion of Jesus in answer to the request of Our Lady of Fatima. She ended her life living on the Eucharist alone for the last 13 years. Alexandrina was born in April 1904. In 1918, the year after the apparitions of Fatima, Alexandrina and her sister Deolinda and another girl were home when three men knocked at the door, one of whom had previously tried to molest Alexandrina. They broke into the house. Alexandrina, to preserve her chastity, jumped from an upstairs window. The men fled, but Alexandrina's spine had been permanently injured and she had to remain in bed for the rest of her life. The slightest movement caused her intense pain. She began to grow closer and closer to the Lord and realized that she was suffering in a special way for the salvation of souls. She received Holy Communion every day and her thoughts frequently turned to Jesus in the tabernacle.
You will not take food again on earth. Your food will be my flesh, your drink will be my divine blood.
So on Good Friday 1942 she began an absolute fast which lasted for the more than 13 years until her death. The only nourishment which her body filled with pain received was Jesus in Holy Communion every morning. News of her fast spread and the crowds became even bigger. Some people had doubts and suspicions about her fast and accused her, her sister and mother, of fraud. Therefore she agreed to medical observation. The doctor asked her, "Why do you not eat?" She replied, "I do not eat because I cannot. I feel full. I do not need it. However, I have a longing for food." It was decided that she should be admitted to a nearby hospital for a 30-day observation of her fast. While she was in the hospital, some tried to persuade her to take food. The doctor in charge of the examination was nasty to her, and at the end of the 30 days said the nurses watching her must have been deceived and decided she was to remain there for a further 10 days. They even showed her tasty food to entice her to eat. When the test was finally over, the doctor said to her he would visit her at home, not as a doctor spy but as a friend who esteems her. Part of the medical report reads as follows. Her abstinence from solids and liquids was absolute during all that time. We testify also that she retained her weight, and her temperature, breathing, blood pressure, pulse and blood were normal, while her mental faculties were constant and lucid, and she had not, during these 40 days, any natural necessities. The laws of physiology and biochemistry cannot account for the survival of this sick woman. While medical science could not explain, the explanation was simple. Jesus had said to Alexandrina,
"You are living by the Eucharist alone, because I want to prove to the world the power of the Eucharist and the power of my life and souls."
She died on October 13, 1955, having received nourishment only from Holy Communion for more than 13 years. Some of the pilgrimages to Fatima visit her town, Balasar, and you can visit her house, see her room, and visit the local church where she is buried to the left of the altar. Blessed Alexandrina offered her life and all of her suffering for the salvation of souls. Let us pray that she intercedes for us today for all the needs of the world in our confusing times. Blessed Alexandrina da Costa, pray for us.